Praise the Lord, everybody. Happy Sunday. Praise the Lord, everybody. God bless you. Come on into the house. It's Sunday service time. Amen, amen. Good to see everyone. Come on, let's enter into praise and worship. Let's enter into service right now. God bless you. Good to see you. As everyone's coming on in, joining on in, come on, let's enter into praise and worship. Thank God for you being here. As we're waiting and letting many join and come on in, we're getting ready for praise and worship. I will bless the Lord at all times. Amen. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I want you to know today that the presence of the Lord is here. Amen. Come on, we can sing it together. Yes, Lord. The presence of the Lord is here. The presence of the Lord is here. Presence of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Spirit of the Lord is here. Power of the Lord is here. Power of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. The power of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. Come on, let's give God some praise and honor this afternoon. Anybody want to put those hands together? Anybody want to serve the Lord with your gladness? Come before His presence with singing. Know it's the Lord that's done it and not ourselves. Yes, Lord, I feel it. The presence of the Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on, let's sing it. Let's give God praise and honor this afternoon. He's worthy, yes He is. We're gonna take it up here. Come on, let's sing. The Spirit
of the Lord is here.
The Spirit of the Lord. I feel it. Spirit of the Lord. Yes, Lord. The Spirit of the Lord. Come on, you say it. Come on, put those glad hands together. We give you glory and honor, Father. Let's take it up again. Each round goes higher and higher. Hallelujah. The power
of the Lord.
Power of the Lord. I'm feeling it. Power of the Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your power. Come on, with those glad hands, every. Sound the alarm. God, He's worthy. He's in His holy temple. Bow before the Lord. Come on, say, let
all the people
praise Him now. Let's give Him all we got. Hallelujah. You're worthy of blessing.
The Lord is here.
A blessing from the Lord.
The Lord is here.
I feel it
in the atmosphere.
Blessing from the Lord. Oh. Yes, Lord. Come on, somebody needs to run around the soul right now. And sound the alarm. This afternoon, the Lord. Let everybody bow. Bow before Him, for His presence. Let Him
praise Him now.
The Lord. Come on, sing the Lord. The Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, put those glad hands together. If you can feel the presence of the Lord, come on, sing. Come on, tenors. Alto, sing. Put those glad hands together. Yes, Lord. My. Good afternoon. Oh, if you don't believe it, if you didn't receive it, oh, we're here to let you know this afternoon that the presence of the Lord is here. Amen. God bless you. Good to see you this afternoon. Your brother, Pastor Charles Carter, the Church One Charlotte family, here and abroad. We want to say God bless you and let you know that the presence of the Lord is here. Can you feel his presence? Oh, you're going to get out of it what you put into it. Come on and enter into praise and worship with us. Who do we have with us so far this afternoon? Amen. Praise God. Trustee Rodney Thompson. Amen. Miss Terry, Mother Terry Little. God bless you. Mother and Chief Missionary Jackie Jackson, amen. Linda Glover, amen. Pastor Tiffany Ann Chin, God bless you. From Church One Alpharetta, God bless you, amen. Shannon Legree, amen. And Pastor Terrell Sarver from Church One Indianapolis. Oh, my goodness. Oh, we going to have some church today. Yes, we are. The pastors are in the house. Lord, have mercy. Oh, we thank him and praise him. We just thank God for your being here. And we want you to know that Jesus is Lord, amen. Oh, no matter what everyone else has to say, no matter what else is going on, God is still on the throne. Amen. Mama Gloria Bennett, good to see you. Amen. And Pop Charles Bennett, God bless you. Sister Lauren Bennett, I didn't read them all. Come on, hold on. And amen. Lady Madge Bass, good to see you all. Amen. And Chief Trustee Charles Bennett, good to see you, Pop. Amen. Praise God for you all. Amen. Did you enjoy that song of praise and worship? Well, let's continue on in praise and worship. Amen. Why? We need to give thanks always. Amen. I know it's not Thanksgiving time, but every day is a day of Thanksgiving. Is that somebody's testimony this afternoon? Come on, let's give him thanks. As we enter into praise and worship, as we prepare to hear a word from the Lord. Come on, let's enter into praise and worship. You can get up out your seat. Come on, let's move. And give God glory and honor because he's worthy yesterday, today, and forevermore. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Come on, put those hands together. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is. Not only that, but he is worthy. Yes, he is. Bless your name. For he is. You're worthy of all the glory. Bless your name. Come on, let's take it up. Unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is. Oh, give thanks. I bless your name. For he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is. Hallelujah. You're worthy, God, of all my praise. For he is. You're worthy. Bless your name. Hallelujah. Come on, let's take it up unto the Lord. God, I give you thanks. I give you praise. Oh, give unto the Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. For he is. Hallelujah. God, you're worthy of all. Our honor and praise. Yes, you are. Come on, put those hands together. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You're worthy, God, unto the Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. For he is good. Yes, he is. For he is. Bless your name. Hallelujah. You're worthy. For he is. Bless your name. You're worthy, God. You're so worthy. Hallelujah. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. All ye lands, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before.
presence with Satan. No, it's that he that has made us and not ourselves. We got to give him thanks today.
For he's worthy.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. You're good, God. Yes, you're good. And you're worthy. Hallelujah. Yes, you are. Hallelujah. Oh, we bless your name. Yes, Lord. Come on, sing it. Tell your neighbor, you're good, God. Oh, I can't tell you enough. 10,000 times are not enough. Hallelujah. You're good. Yes, you are. Hallelujah. Yes. One more time. Bring it around. Get it in your spirit. You're good, God. Bless your name. Keep it coming. Hallelujah. You're worthy. Hallelujah. You're good. Bless your name. Bless your high name. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. God bless you once again. Your brother, Pastor Charles Carter, the Church One Charlotte family. We say a good morning and a good God bless you. Chief Audio Video Technician Mark Elmore, good to see you. Prophet Terrence Culp, good to see you. Amen. Amen. And Pastor Prophet Sherry Cribb. Amen. Oh, my goodness. Good to see all the saints in the house this afternoon. Oh, if you didn't know, the Lord is good. Amen. And his mercy endures forever. I'm about to get excited. Oh, come on. Leia, you got to run grab me a towel real quick, honey. I'm getting carried away before I even get started. Amen. Deacon Lamar Evans. Amen. Sister Kayla Goodwin. Amen. We thank God for you all being with us. Amen. The Lord is good. Amen. And his mercy endures forever. Amen. Grace is God giving us what we don't deserve. Mercy is God not giving us what we do deserve. Lord, have mercy. Oh, goodness, goodness, goodness. Amen. We thank him for his mercy this afternoon. Amen. As always, we thank God. District missionary LaShonda Carter's in the house. Amen. Praise God for her. Kaylin Layla in the house. Amen. Kaya away at school. She's in the house. Amen. Praise God for you, the people of God. We give him thanks and praise always. Amen. Why? Because 10,000 tongues are not enough to give God praise and honor for all his goodness. Amen. Thank you. God bless you. Oh yeah. I had to get my towel here this afternoon. Amen. Oh, the saints getting me excited early. Amen. Amen. Let's go to the word this afternoon. We thank God for all of you that are joining us. We also want to thank God, and we'll be making contact with all of our Church One Charlotte family. We've got a special Word Wednesday on Wednesday night. Amen. None other than the Chief Apostle. Amen. Wayne Manning Bass is going to be with us. We thank God for him. This is going to be for Church One Charlotte only. Amen. So this one, we won't be broadcasting live, but we'll be making sure we're doing a direct Zoom with our Church One Charlotte family. I believe I saw Brother Wilbert Nils Jr. in the house also. Praise God for you. So make sure you got your ears on. Amen. Church One Charlotte family, so that we can be in the house. Y'all know that Apostle Bass, he joins us, you know, quarterly on a regular basis in most instances. So we're not allowing the enemy to get in the way of that. Amen. Just because we're virtual. Oh no, we can come together. Amen. Amen. We make all effort to keep the fellowship of the saints together, as scripture says. It says to forsake it not. Amen. Why? Because you'll be amazed what happens if you get alone on your own for a little too long. Amen. The enemy will start trying to discourage you. That's why we're here today, to encourage somebody's spirit. Amen. James, the first chapter. As you can see right here, our topic scripture should be right here to my left, your right. James, the first chapter. I'm going to start at verse 18, but we're going to read verses. I'm sorry. I'm going to start at verse 17, but we're going to read verses 17 and 18. And our focus is going to be right here at verse 18. Amen. Praise God for you. When you got it, say, I got it. Amen. Go ahead and post a little. I got it. Amen. That means you've got your word. Your word, as scripture says, is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Watch out when you start hearing too much opinion and not enough word. Lord have mercy. Amen. We're going straight to the word. Amen. If you got it, all right, I'm going to read in your hearing. I'm going to start and read the King James Version, and I might touch on the NIV and New King James also, because these translations really shed some wonderful light, I believe. Amen. James, the first chapter, starting at verse 17. King James Version reads, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness. Come on, say variableness. Yes, indeed. That's our $10 word for today. Neither shadow of turning. Verse 18 in the King James, it reads, of his own will begat he us with the word of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruits of his creations. Amen. King James says first fruits of his creatures. Amen. I want to jump back reading that in the NIV. It reads like this. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. Oh my goodness. That's important right there. Make sure you hold on to that. Verse 18, he chose to give us birth through the word of truth, that we might be a kind of first fruits of all he created. Come on, somebody, thank God for the word as it is written. Brother Darren Floyd, good to see you. God bless you. Amen. I want to share a word from the word today. And I believe God wants to share it with us. He wants to speak to us in a special way on this afternoon. Come on, tell yourself that you're first. Amen. Yes, indeed. It doesn't matter how many people are in your family. Doesn't matter how many different people are part of your job. Doesn't matter where you are on the socioeconomic status board. God wants you to know today that you're first. Amen. Praise his name. Missionary Marion Williams, God bless you. Thank God for all the wonderful work Missionary Marion Williams is doing with Purpose and Peace, sharing the good news and sharing the very substance that God is making and using us to be a conduit to share with those in need. Praise God for her. Amen. Amen. Tell yourself this afternoon that you're first. Amen. I know that the Olympics was supposed to be going on. I know that there are various sporting activity groups that are making every effort to continue their seasons for the sake of getting to the playoffs to determine who's first. Amen. Oh, but God is wanting to share with us today. God is wanting to reach us right where we are and let us know today that we are first. Amen. What are you talking about, preacher? James 1 and 18 says, of his own will begat he us with the word of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Amen. Yes, because I know, come on, Bible scholars, I know many of us can jump back to Genesis, amen, and recognize that we maybe weren't the first things created. Amen. In the beginning, even as you read in scripture, John, the first chapter talks about it. Genesis talks about it, where it talks about the beginning. And as my Bible scholars will point out, I know you will recognize quickly that God had to create some things before he created you and me. Lord, have mercy. Even if we're looking at the span of time, even if we're looking at the infinite number of ancestors that have come before us, you can say, I'm really having a problem right now trying to realize how I could be first. But God is wanting to share with us today that you are first. Amen. Praise his name. Amen. We thank God for this passage of scripture. And even as we're experiencing right now, such a laundry list of firsts. We're experiencing so many things for the first time in many instances. Young believers, young people, whatever your age group might be, there are various things that you are probably happening that you're coming across on a daily basis that you have to say, wait a minute, I believe this is the first time I've experienced this. Amen. Let me go talk to somebody that might know or have a little bit more insight on it, because right now I'm experiencing a first. Amen. Many of us are going to school at home for the first time. Amen. And many of us are even here in the Carolinas are experiencing unexpected weather conditions for the first time. Yes, indeed. About 2 weeks ago, we had an earthquake, which is not a regular occurrence in the Carolinas. Amen. I know our brothers in of Church 1 DMV or Church 1 Indianapolis or Church 1 Alpharetta, maybe even Church 1 California, whenever the Lord blesses, amen, will say, man, that's nothing. I'm from areas that experience that on a regular basis. But as far as the Carolinas go, there is an unexpected first that took place happened where not only was it an earthquake, but it was a rather recognizable one. 5 point plus on the Richter scale. Amen. Sister Altria Wilson, God bless you. Good to see you. Amen. So, you know, we're experiencing firsts on a regular basis. Even right now, for all my weather watchers in the Gulf of Mexico, there is the potential for two hurricanes to be happening basically at the same time in the same general area. Many are saying this is if it's not the first ever, it's definitely the first in a long time. Amen. We were talking about our sports teams. Many are experiencing playing for the first time without a live audience in many instances. You turn on some of the different sporting events, and they're even using modern technology to try to spice things up a little bit. Amen. Can get a little quiet watching a baseball game with nobody at the game. Amen. Oh, my goodness. You say, is the game happening or not? Lord have mercy. So I don't know if you've seen it, but the New York Yankees got real fancy, and they put a virtual crowd behind home plate. Amen. Not just the little cardboard cutouts that some of them are doing, but they're doing many things that they have not had to do in the past. They're doing it for the first time. Yes, indeed. You know, NBA, they're playing all in the same place, and they put up big old screens around the court to try to create a level of activity and excitement during the game. Because many can say, my goodness, without the crowd, Lord have mercy, is this a scrimmage or is this practice or is this the real deal? No, they're having to make every effort to make sure that they are getting things done like they need to be, even though it might be for the first time. Sister Nikki, good to see you. Amen. God bless you. Amen. So we're experiencing a lot of different occurrences for the first time. Firsts are interesting because they present a surprise of unexpectedness. Amen. Yes, that's one of our Church One Charlotte words that it's time to add that one to the dictionary. Unexpectedness. Amen. Praise his name. That there is something that comes about from a first, and it's a surprise of being unexpected. It's something that can catch us off guard because it's outside of the norm. A first can make you very excited. It might make you a little uneasy because you're not necessarily sure how to handle it. Amen. But still, it's a first, and it causes a level of surprise. Yes, it does. First will show you what's important. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Who is that joining us? Amen. Brother Ralph and Adrian. I can't make that out. Alexander, God bless you. Good to see you. Amen. Praise his name. But it shows us what's important. Firsts, in many instances, will show us what's important based on how we handle them. Amen. Not necessarily because of the order that it came in, that you received it, but how we dispense it. Amen. Whether it be our own personal treasure. Scripture says, you know, that where a man's heart, where his treasure is, there is his heart also. Why? Because where your treasure is what you make the most effort on first. Amen. What's important to us is going to be what we make a lot of effort and a lot of action on first. Amen. Proverbs 3:9 says to honor the Lord with the first fruits of your increase. Amen. That's saying that if I love God, if it's important to me, I'm going to make effort toward God first. Amen. Praise his name. When I get up, I need to make an effort to talk to him first. Yes, indeed. When I'm going about my day, when I'm going about the various things I do, whatever I do first shows how important it is to me. Amen. Hallelujah. And God is trying to let us know this afternoon that you are first. You are created as a form of first fruits of his creation. Amen. That means no matter if the firmament was made first, you're first in God's eyes. Amen. Scripture says that heaven and earth are going to pass away, but my word will stand, and his word is there first. Yes, indeed. For us to grab hold of. This passage of scripture in James 1:18 is really interesting. Amen. And I got to grab hold of some things I want you to take a look at. It says in 18, of his own will, he begot us with the word of truth. I like how the King James touches on this because it begins to share with us information. It begins to share with us how the Holy Trinity was even at work in reference to us. Amen. God is saying that he begat us with the word of truth. Amen. The word, as scripture says, was God. And the word was with God. And what this scripture is trying to let us know in James, the word of truth was there, and it was there to make sure that nothing gets in the way of us recognizing God's purpose, God's plan, and his focus toward us. Lord have mercy. Before I even go there, I gotta back up just a little bit. Amen. Because in that passage, it says of his own will, he begot us. Amen. I want you to know today that many of us, you have recognized this passage of scripture, and you're even realizing right now that you are so important. Scripture says God willed it with the word of truth. Amen. I don't know who around or sharing with us today has ever willed something. Amen. What am I saying? It's, you know, when you will something to be, you say, you know what? It doesn't matter what comes to pass. It doesn't matter what's going on around me. It doesn't matter who's with me or against me. I'm going to will this thing to happen. Lord have mercy. The scripture is showing us right here that God was not going to allow anything to cause his feeling toward us to be misinterpreted. Amen. It says in the passage right here, there was nothing that was going to cause God to not make us come to pass. Lord Jesus, I know somebody's asking themselves from time to time, God, what is your will for my life? God, what is it that you would have me to do? I'm not even sure about if you're really concerned with me with all that is taking place and transpiring. Well, God is letting us know today, amen, that not only am I concerned, but I have willed this thing that is you to come to pass. Meaning what? Doesn't matter what's happening around. Doesn't matter who's speaking up or down. Doesn't matter what type of situation that you're in. I've willed you to be first. Yes, indeed. Lord have mercy. My will according to you, sister girl. My will according to you, brother man, as saith the Lord, is that which you have to understand, that first is important. And nothing stands in a greater posture with me than you, my creation, saith the Lord. Lord, have mercy. I want to encourage somebody's spirit today. Amen. God is not surprised or taken aback. He's not the first fruit of his creation is who he is stating us to be. Amen. He has focused and putting you first. Yes, indeed. And if God is putting you first, that means that whatever you put your hands to, according to the will of God, is going to work in your favor. As God has putting you first, you need to put God first. Yes, indeed. You need to make sure that there's nothing standing in the way. Amen. We got to make sure that there's nothing standing up against the very will that God is exerting toward us. My God, today, have you ever been in that position and where you said, you know what? It doesn't matter if people get on board or not. This thing is happening. Amen. You will that thing to happen. Whether it was something at your job, something a part of ministry, something in your family, didn't matter what it was. You made up in your mind that, you know what? I'm not going to allow anything to fall short and to keep this from taking place. God is trying to let us know today, I have willed you to be. And there is nothing that's going to stand in the way of my will being done in your life and your very creation that you are being made good and pleasing. Lord Jesus, you thought we had already left verse 17 alone. Amen. I know somebody thought that we had just kind of read verse 17 for the sake of reading it and we had moved on. But in verse 17 in James, the first chapter, the scripture writer is letting us know that every good and perfect gift comes from above. Amen. And if God is willing this thing to happen, amen, it's not going to be less than his best. If God has willed us to be, he's not going to cause us to be in any way less than first. Amen. Praise his name. Somebody is having a hard time grabbing hold to that because you are used to coming in second. Amen. You are used to not even being on the leaderboard. But I want you to know today that God's will for your life, yes, indeed, is a will to come in first. Why does that mean that, you know, you have to be trying to make every effort and, you know, doing anything and trying to manufacture wins? No, you just have to get yourself in a posture of understanding God, as you have willed me to be so, you have willed me to be a first fruit of your creation. And as you have willed it to be
already so and made up in your mind that no matter what comes our way, God, you have willed it and it's going to come to pass. Yes, it is. Oh, somebody's concerned today. Somebody's concerned about a delay. Somebody is concerned about something that may appear to be a denial. We want to share with you from the word today in James, the first chapter, 18th verse, that as we are his first fruits of his creation, God has all mind toward working things out for our good. Yes, he does. Amen. The scripture that we're reading shows that God the Father isn't working alone on this one. Amen. The very word of truth. Amen. Amen. The word made flesh we recognize as Christ. Amen. The word that was with God. Amen. In the beginning was working in tandem when the consideration of who we were in reference to God was being the conversation was being had. I can hear the conversation being had about all of the various things that had been created. But there was something special. Amen. That had to be created. That was greater than anything that had been created and that would be created. Amen. There was something, yes, it was, that was important. There was something that had to be very important to get the type of recognition of being first. Amen. You don't put that on just anything. Amen. You don't put that on that title on anything that does anything any kind of way. No, you put that recognition on that which is most important. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise God that as we're looking at this passage of scripture, God willed us as a first fruit. And it means no matter what comes our way, God is trying to touch your heart today. He's trying to prick your spirit to come up from where you are to where he would have us to be. Praise his name. He's trying to let us know today that the very word of truth was a part of making us who we are. That's why you can't stand amongst falsehood, but for so long. Amen. That's why things that are incorrect, even if there are those that would attempt to try to adopt falsehoods, it can't last. Why? Because the very word of truth has been created and put on the inside of you, his first fruits. Amen. And as the word of truth has been a part of our very creation, as the scripture says, there is nothing and no one that can stand in the way of the very first fruit mark that God has put on you. Sister Tennille Faust, God bless you. Good to see you. Amen. God is trying to let us know today, and he is saying that no matter what the circumstances say, no matter what you're expecting on tomorrow, no matter what someone else has been labeling you as up to this point, amen, no matter how you even think about yourself right now, God is trying to let you know that my will, yes it is, for you is life, in your life is gonna happen, yes it is, no matter what things that seem like obstacles, no matter what challenges seem like they're going to get the best of us, God's will, his very will, and his word of truth is that which is going to carry you from where you are to where God would have you to be. I know you can remember that bake sale, amen. I know you can remember that concert. I know you can remember that project you had at work. I know you can remember that study class or that test that you may have had. You at some point got in your mind that no matter what is trying to keep me from this being a success, I am going to will this thing to happen. God is telling you today, no matter what is coming your way, no matter what has already taken place, no matter what your past, present or future might seem to be, God is letting you know that this thing is going to happen, and it's going to happen. Why? Because I'm willing it to be so on your behalf. Praise his name. We can't be weary in well-doing. The Bible says, but you shall reap in due season if you faint not. The enemy is making an effort right now to cause us to want to faint. The enemy is making an effort right now to cause you to think other firsts that you are experiencing right now are in some way, shape, or form going to outdo the very firsts that God has declared in his word. There's so much going on that the enemy is attempting to overwhelm you with. But as the word of the Lord states today, that there is nothing that's greater than the will of God for our lives. The Bible says in this passage, he willed it to be so, that we would not only be created, but created with the word of truth. Hallelujah. And he did it in this way that we might be recognized as first. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. You need to lift up your spirit right now. You need to give God honor right now, because God has declared you first. Yes, he has. He's not allowing anything to be considered greater than you right now. He's not allowing anything, the very thoughts that he has towards you, to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you hope and a future. These very thoughts that God has are the thoughts that he has for his first fruits. Praise his name. And if God cares for us that much, that means no matter what comes our way, it's gonna happen. Praise his name. No matter what you're experiencing right now, God's will for your life is gonna happen. No matter what you may even have attempted to do on your own, to walk away from God's plan, his will is greater even than our disobedience. This word is coming right now to encourage somebody that's trying to go and do it their own way, to come back to God's way. Mother Lisa Evans, God bless you. Good to see you. God's will for our life with the word of truth is that we would recognize we are his very first fruits. Praise his name. Now somebody's saying, I don't even know how this works. I don't even know how to go about being a part of this will that you're talking about. If you've never asked Christ into your heart, if you've never received the invitation to Christian discipleship, I want to offer Christ to you today. How do I receive him into my heart? All of these church terms keep me kind of lost in the sauce. Just pray this prayer with me. God, I know I'm a sinner. God, I believe you died for my sins. Save me right now. I believe and I confess with my mouth. I believe in my heart that you died for my sins. And right now, I believe I'm saved. That's not just a mouth confession, as Romans 10:9-10 states, but it's a mouth confession and it's a heart belief. As you pray that prayer with your mouth, now you walk it out with your very heart belief. Scripture talks about the heart in reference to our will. Haven't we been talking about the will a whole lot today? Our very will is what we want to do. Just like we will something to happen, we're willing it. This mouth confession to be more than just talk. With our mouth confession is made to salvation, with a heart belief is unto righteousness. Your heart belief is what's going to will you to walk this thing out. As we wrap up today, if you've received Christ as your personal Savior today, get in contact with us. We want to pray with you. We want to continue to share the word of truth with you. Amen. His word is sharper than any two-edged sword. And it's his very word that's a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Amen. Hallelujah. We magnify his name this afternoon. And as we wrap up, we want to give his name glory. Because I believe somebody is making a closer walk choice today to say, God, I'm trusting you. I've tried it my own way, but now I'm trusting you. We magnify your name. Glorify your name. Oh God. Oh, we magnify your name. Glorify your name. You to remember that Jesus is Lord. His will for your life. He's gonna make it happen. Yes, he is. He's created you first. Yes, he has. As a first fruit of all his creation. God bless you. God bless you, Brother Brian Young. Good to see you. We'll see you next week. Have a blessed week.